student, now we are going to see example 2.35. In NAP, the sum of first n terms is 5n squared by 2 plus 3n by 2. Find the 17th term. So sum of first n terms means nothing but Sn. So they given Sn equal to 5n squared by 2 plus 3n by 2. We are going to find the 17th term. 17th term means T17. If they given like this, how to find T17? Already I told in previous sum. That is S17. Sum of first 17 terms minus sum of first 16 terms. Then only we get the 17th term. Okay. So given in an AP, Sn equal to 5n squared by 2 plus 3n by 2. So find, we are going to find S17. S17 equal to 5 into, instead of n, we are going to substitute 17. 17 squared by 2 plus 3 into 17 by 2. So 17 squared is 289. So 5 into 289 by 2 plus 3 into 17 by 2. So multiply this, will get 1445 by 2 plus 51 by 2. Here the denominators are same. So write 2, add the numerators. If you add these 2, will get 1496 by 2. Divide into 2 table, will get 748. That is S17 equal to 748. Next, find S16 equal to, so here also the same. Substitute instead of n, 16. 5 into 16 square by 2 plus 3 into 16 by 2. 16 square, I write 16 into 16 because it will be easy to cancel. So 2 1s are, 2 8s are, here 8s are, 3 8s are, you will get 24. If you add these 2 numbers, you will get 664. That is S16 equal to 664. So they asked to find 17th term. 17th term equal to T17 equal to S17 minus S16. S17 what we found? 748 minus S16 is 664. If you subtract, you will get 84. So 17th term equal to 84. Did you understand this? Next, move on to example 2.37. A mosaic is designed in the shape of a equilateral triangle, 12 feet on each side. Each side is in the mosaic in the shape of an equilateral triangle of 12 each side. The tiles are alternate in color as shown in the figure. Find the number of tiles of each color and total number of tiles in the mosaic. So a mosaic is there. The mosaic is in the shape of equilateral triangle. What is meant by equilateral triangle? The three sides should be equal. No. So they given that is 12 feet. So here I draw one triangle. That is 12 feet. Equilateral triangle. The three sides should be equal to 12 feet. Then in that triangle, each tile in the mosaic, in that mosaic is in the shape of an equilateral triangle. Again, in that triangle, we have small triangles like this. That is also equilateral triangle. Each side of the triangle is 12 inch. 12 inch is nothing but 1 feet. Okay. So the tiles are alternate in color as shown in the figure. If you see here, there are alternate colors. That is white and blue colors. Okay. So find the number of tiles in each color. We are going to find number of tiles in each color. That is how many blue color tiles are there. Since the mosaic is in the shape of equilateral triangle, that is of 12 feet, and the tile is in the shape of equilateral triangle, 12 inch, 1 feet. So there will be how many rows in the mosaic now? 12 rows. Why we are writing 12 rows now? That is 12 feet. And then each triangle is 1 feet, you know. So we will get 12 rows in this mosaic. Okay. So from the figure it is clear that the number of white tiles. So this is the first row, second row, third row like this. In first row you have only one white color tile. In second row you have two white color tiles. In third row three white color tiles. So you can write it as from the figure that white tiles in each row are 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. If you select the last row, then you 12 white color tiles. Okay, so which is clearly forms an AP. So that is a natural numbers, you know, definitely it is in AP. So similarly, the number of blue tiles. See, in this first row, there is no blue tile. So first, second row also. So first row, there is no blue tile. We are going to take 0. In second row, we have only one blue tile. In third row, we have two blue tiles. Okay. So the blue tiles will be 0, 1, 2 like that. Last row, you will get, here in last row, you have 11 blue tiles. Okay, so similarly the number of blue tiles in each row are 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, 11, which is also an AP. Next, number of white tiles. So if you add these, you will get total number of white tiles. Okay, so 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on, 12, then it is AP. So you know the last term also, what is the SL formula? SL equal to N by 2 into A plus L. Here A equal to first term 1, last term 12, and number of rows are 12. Here N is number of rows. How many rows are there in that mosaic, that is? Okay, so S 12 equal to 12 by 2 into 1 plus 12. 1 plus 12 will get 13. Here cancel these 2 ones are 2, 6 are 6 into 13 will get 78. So number of white tiles equal to 78. Next, move on to the blue tiles. Blue tiles now you have to start from 0. That is 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on, 11. If you add these, you will get number of blue tiles. It is also in AP. So last term also you know that is 11. Right, A equal to 0, that is first term is 0, L equal to 11, and number of rows here also 12. So N is 12. Like the formula SL equal to N by 2 into A plus L, S 12 equal to 12 by 2 into A is 0 plus L is 11. So cancel this 2 1s are 2 6 are 6 into 11 will get 66. So S 12, S 12 means number of blue balls equal to, sorry, blue tiles equal to 66 tiles. They ask total number of tiles also. Therefore, the total number of tiles, how will you get? Add both white tiles and blue tiles. That is 78 plus 66, you will get 144 tiles. So total number of tiles is 144. So do you understand this? Example 2.38, the house of a street are numbered from 1 to 49. Sendil's house is numbered such that the sum of the numbers of the houses prior to Sendil's house is equal to the sum of the numbers of the houses following Sendil's house. Find Sendil's house number. So look at this. Imagine this is a street. Okay. So somewhere Sendil's house is there. Imagine this is the Sendil's house. Okay. House numbers are given like this. Here 1, next house 2, next house 3, like that. Total number of houses in that street are, that is the number given like this, 1 to 49. So the house of a street are numbered from 1 to 49. Sendil's house is numbered such that they given Sendil's house number, that is sum of the numbers of the houses prior. Prior is nothing but before. Before Sendil's house numbers. If add the house numbers of before Sendil, then Sendil's house is equal to, that is equal to sum of the numbers of the houses following means next after Sendil house. So that must be equal. So we are going to find Sendil's house number. So if I doesn't know the Sendil's house number, so now I am assuming that X. So what will be the before Sendil house before number? X minus 1. What will be the next number? Next house number now? X plus 1. Next house number? X plus 2. Like that. Okay. So they given that before Sendil house, that is from 1 to X minus 1. Sum means we are going to add. So 1 to X minus 1, if you add, you will get next to Sendil's house. From X plus 1 to 49, if you add now, both will be equal. They given that condition. Using that condition, we are going to find what is the number of Sendil's house. Okay. So let Sendil's house number be X. So here I assume Sendil's number is, house number is X. So it is given that is before Sendil's house, now you get from 1 to x minus 1. Add this 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on x minus 1, which is equal to after seven house, that is x plus 1 to 49. That is x plus 1 plus x plus 2 plus and so on plus 49. Here the sequence series starts from 1 only. See this here, the series starts from x plus 1. We doesn't know that x plus x value variable. Okay. So now we are going to change this and writing like this. So this one will be are going to write now. How can I write means 1 to 49 I am taking and then I am subtracting this. That is from 1 to 7 house number. Then I will get this no. So from 1 to 49 I am going to subtract 1 to x. That only I get 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on 49 minus 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on x. Definitely I will get this x plus 1 plus x plus 2 plus and so on 49. Why I am writing this now? So that x value I doesn't know whether it satisfies the series on AP or not, we doesn't know. That's why we are changing and write like this. Okay, so SN formula here also last term you know, here 49, here x you know. Then you can use SN formula n by 2 into a plus. So consider this series. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on plus x minus 1 now will get a equal to 1 and last term that is x minus 1 and also number of terms will be x minus 1. Next take this series that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on 49. Here a will be 1, last term is 49 and the number of terms also 49. So take this 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on x. Here a equal to 1, l equal to x, next n equal to x, x1. Okay. Now I am going to substitute in that formula, SN formula, that is n by 2 into a plus l equal to, for that sequence you have to substitute separately. You will get x minus 1 by 2 into 1 plus x minus 1 equal to 49 by 2 into 1 plus 49 minus x by 2 into 1 plus x. Now we are going to simplify this. Plus 1 minus 1 will get cancelled. X minus 1 by 2 into x equal to 49 by 2. 1 plus 49 will get 50. X by 2 into 1 plus x. Now multiply with this x, you will get x square minus x by 2 equal to. Now you can multiply these two, 2450 divided by 2. Minus here also multiply with this x. X plus x square will get divided by 2. Okay, now write x square minus x by 2. Here these two are, the denominators are same. You can directly subtract the numerator. Write 2450 minus, this minus also will be multiplied, you know. So you can write minus x minus x square. And these two goes that side now, both will get cancelled. You can cancel it directly. So x square minus x equal to 2450 minus x minus x square. Send the variable term to the left hand side. You will get x square minus x minus x square comes this side now plus x square minus x plus x equal to 2450. So minus x plus x will get cancelled. X square plus x square will get 2x square equal to 2450. X square equal to 2450 divided by 2. Cancel this, you will get x square equal to 1225. This is nothing but 35. X equal to 35, you get plus or minus 35. House number will not be negative, no. And also they given house numbers varies from 1 to 49 only. So therefore, Sendil's house number is 35. That's all, my dear children.